Are we going to talk about Mathemat?
Mathemat.
So just a few words about me. I'm working for the AccessiTech project, whose goal is to make scientific documents accessible to visually impaired people. And I've also been a volunteer contributor to the Mozilla Mathemat project for several years. Mathemat is important for accessibility, but today I'm going to focus on the visual rendering of mathematical formulas. So, 2 years ago, thanks to a crowdfunding project, I was able to spend some time on the Mathemat implementation of Gecko and WebKit. And more specifically, I've worked on the so-called math table, which is an open type table which is available in some math forms. And this table is very important for the visual rendering of mathematical formulas, so I'm going back to this at the end of my talk. But first I'm going to give a quick overview of Mathemat. So for those who don't know, Mathemat is an XML language to describe mathematical notations. So it has been standardized at W3C and at ISO. So here is an example of a Mathemat formula in Gecko. It has also been included in other formats, like the one used in LibreOffice, or in electronic books, or audiobooks. But for the most important for us is HTML5, because that means that we can include the mathematical formulas in web pages like Wikipedia, or web apps like Firefox REST web apps, because they are based on HTML5. Or if you write a HTML email, you can write a question inside your email. So let's look more carefully at Mathemat in HTML5. So this is a basic example. This is just a Mathemat question inside the HTML5 page, and it is rendered by Gecko. But the thing that is interesting with Mathemat is that we can mix with other web technologies. So for example, Dominic talked about text layout yesterday. And so of course we can just use Unicode characters and typographic features. So here we just use Arabic characters to display a formula as it is done probably in Morocco. We can also use directional ability. So there is a dir attribute in Mathemat, and we can so display the formula from right to left. So there is a square which is displayed from right to left. So this is most common in Arabic countries. So of course, if you want to style your formula, you can just use CSS. So here you should notice that I've used a specific font. I'm using the font family in Protopy, and I've just used a basic selector to put the numerator of the fraction in blue. So of course, the Mathemat also has a DOM tree, and we can use JavaScript to modify it. It will be updated automatically. So this is interesting if you do some interactive math. For example, if you want to bet web apps in education, you can just use interactive things like this. So you can also use the foreign object element of SVG to embed Mathemat inside SVG images. So obviously this is important to get scientific schemas. Since the SVG can in turn be embedded inside a canvas, and since you can use WebGL to draw inside the canvas, you can create three-dimensional representation. So here you just have the Mathemat inside the SVG inside the WebGL. And so this is useful if you want to see, for example, three-dimensional things that are harder to see otherwise. So you can play with it. And And also I'd just like to mention that, of course, there are many. So people who are used to write equation in LaTeX can also use LaTeX to convert it to MATLAB. So many converters like that. You can, so there are some converters written in JavaScript, of course. And if you can, for example, create a web component's custom element that takes its content as LaTeX, converts it into MATLAB, and puts this MATLAB DOM into the shadow tree, and then lets the browser render the shadow tree. So you have just like an extract element and you render it. So this is great. So now the current issues. All the demos I've shown so far were rendered in Gecko. Unfortunately, that's only red rendering engine that has good MathML support. So for users, this means that they have to use fallback or alternative, and this is of course a bit painful. Another problem is that math is not a priority for browser vendors, which means that if we want to do MathML development, we have to rely on volunteer work or doing work with Fest each year, or doing portfolio project, and of course that's not really reliable to do good progress. Finally, another issue is that the Math Working Group has developed the MathML as an independent XML language, and they were not really focused on what the web engine people want. So sometimes there's something like they don't really give the details of how to run the things, and it's hard to implement it to work on MathML. Also, they have a test script, but the tests are not automated. They are just basically examples with a PNG image, so of course it's really hard to get them and to understand them and to put into our test framework. So that's not really easy to use. So how to solve these issues? So this year I created the MathML Association with some other people. So it's a recursive acronym for Mondial Association for Tool Handling MathML LTD. And it's a non-profit organization under the state of New York. So our goal is to create a community that will, on the one hand, clearly states that mathematics on the web is important and that it should be treated as any other human language. And on the other hand, to gather the technical and financial resources to support mathematical development. So for example, I know from my portfolio project that there are many individuals and companies who are interested in mathematics supporting browser, even if they don't have technical knowledge to have. And for example, many of them donated to my conflict project, and I hope that with a non-profit organization we could raise more funds. Also, while working on MathML, I've been in touch with many experts, so phone designers or browser vendors, and we can bring the technical knowledge if we are able to have some time and some money to work on this. So besides doing the initial setup and paperwork, we're also working on a very important document, which is the MathML HTML5 definition note. So in this document, we try to clearly define how to lay out formulas using the math table, the contact math table that I mentioned at the beginning. And this is what we have used during the ACFest too. So this is going to be very helpful to improve the math rendering in browsers instead of using the MathML spec, which is sometimes a bit unclear. And additionally, we are of course starting to write a test suite, which will use the ref test and scripts test, so things that web browsers are used to. So now I'm going back to the OpenTAP math. So this paper was initially created by Microsoft for the Microsoft Office, so for the mathematical modeling in Microsoft Office. It was later implemented in other open source tools like LaTeX engines that are aware of OpenType. It was also implemented in tools like FontForge, so you can use FontForge to edit the math table and create your own math fonts. And finally, this year it was also included in the open font format, so it is not standard. If we look at the supporting operating system, so currently Windows, Microsoft provides the Cambria font on Windows, so which has math support. So by default, we have an OpenType math table on Windows. That's not really the case on other operating systems right now, so that's something that we would like to improve. So for example, I talked with Dominic about the Noto font, which is used in Android, and there is a bug request to initiate an announcement request to add the math support to the Noto font. But there is also many fonts that are built inside the LaTeX distributions. So since LaTeX distributions are easily installable on Linux, you can also have the fonts on Linux if you install them. So what about the working web engines now? So most of this was done during my Confonic project. So the first thing is that the math table support was added to the OpenType font sanitizer, which is used in Blink and Gecko. So this means that you can use web fonts with a math table. So even if it's not installed with the operating system, you can still use web fonts. I don't see WebKit as a sanitizer, so we don't have this problem. And in WebKit and Gecko, the font backend now has something to parse the binary data of the math table and expose it via an API. And finally, the MathML layout in Gecko and WebKit is now able to partially use this API to run the MathML. So what is in this table? There are essentially three subtables. So the most obvious extension of text layout for math is the ability to stretch some operators to an arbitrary size. So this is a bit similar to what Dominic talked yesterday. So the first thing is that you have the base size, so you have a character. And if you want to provide larger size, there is one obvious way, is just to provide glyphs in the fonts that are larger. So this part for the smaller size. If you want to stretch to an arbitrary size, you have to use glyph assembly. So you have some pieces like this. So these are the glyphs. You have a bottom glyph, middle glyph, top glyph, and you have some extenders. So the extenders can be repeated as many times as needed to stretch over the top. So this is implemented in Gecko and WebKit now. So here it looks like in Gecko. So we have the base, a larger Vion glyph, and the glyph assembly. This one is actually a horizontal arrow, but I've created my own font with FontForge and my own glyph, so I've built my own construction, just to show that it is supporting Gecko and WebKit. So also for the math rendering, it's really important to respect what the font designer asks about the spacing and the line thickness, the position of scripts, and so on. So this is contained in the math constant subtable. So if we look at the fraction, for example, the MathML spec only says that the frac element has two children, the numerator and denominator, and doesn't really say more about that. They talk about this line thickness attribute, but they don't say what is the default value of the line thickness, so you have to guess it. If you also look to this, you see that there, this is the baseline of the text. And here, this is the mass axis. So the operator stretched symmetrically against the mass axis, with respect to the mass axis. The plus sign is aligned on the mass axis, and so is the fraction. So the problem is that fonts don't have this property of mass axis. And you have to add it you have to read it from the math level. So just to see, in your opinion, how many parameters do you need to lay out this fraction? Does anyone know? So I already mentioned two parameters, the line thickness and the axis height, which is the mass axis. So if you read the MATLAB in HTML5, specification, implementation notes, you see that you have something like gaps like this between the numerator and the fraction bar, between the denominator and the fraction bar too, and you have some shift and so on. You have to take into account the fact that this can be in display mode and inline mode, which is different. If the thickness is zero, the rules are different again. So at the end, you have something like 16 parameters to lay out the fraction. So obviously, that's not something that you can deduce from just reading the MATLAB spec alone. And finally, the third table that is used in the mass table is the same than the MATLAB constant, but instead of giving generic parameters, we give one parameter for a specific leaf. So here, for the integral, you can have the Teddy correction, which essentially says how slant is the integral bit. So this is very important for the position of scripts. So if you see, for example, the naive implementation that is done in WebKit, you just look at the bounding box of the base, and you put scripts just next to the base. Obviously, this doesn't work for the integral because you have to take into account the slant, and the scripts are not in line. So at the moment, okay, this is not done, but this is done later. So just to conclude, I'll give a quick roadmap on MATML in web engines. So the first thing is that, as you probably noticed, math fonts are really important. So we would like to have this everywhere. We would like to have more fonts and fonts installed on operating systems. So I hope that the MATLAB solution will help to do that. The math expert and browser expert should also work together to review the MATLAB in HTML5 document implementation note and give the feedback and try to improve it, try to implement it, and so on, and see if we get something good. And of course, we need also to write more tests so that we get a cross-compatible implementation and a very solid working implementation with hash wandering quality. So, about WebKit now. So, during the Hackfest, we have done some. Actually, Alejandro already started the code refactoring before the Hackfest, but we moved again during the Hackfest. So I don't know if you remember about the current implementation in WebKit, but we are just using flex boxes. So this is first limited, as I said, for example, in the example placement of integrals. But additionally, this is really not convenient to deal with, and we would like to remove the flexbox and just use a simple implementation as it is done in Waco and Gecko. So this is some details are given on the wiki, on the Hackfest wiki, and I think Alejandro is already sent an email to the WebKit mailing list to propose his new branch and try to remove the flexbox links and continue the work. So after we do that, we hope that we could, that would be easier to implement the MATLAB in HTML5 document. And in the long term, when we get a good implementation in NetKit, we would have to consider to import this implementation to Blink. So during the math session, we also mentioned alternatives in Blink, like writing the other implementation or something like that. So we have to consider various options. In Gecko, the implementation is something like 15 years old. There are still some old code that didn't exist when that was done, even when the math table didn't exist. So what we have to do is once the fonts with the math table are widely available, we probably have to clean up the code and remove support for old fonts. And finally, so Servo, I think Martin mentioned, talk about Servo last year. So it's a web engine developed by Mozilla. It's a new web engine. And if you want to implement MathML, we'll have to do a new implementation. And this, of course, will be interesting to do a clean implementation using the MathML in HTML5 specification. So that's it. My RC nickname, if you have a question, is here with my address. If you're interested in the MathML association of the MathML HTML5 implementation node and want to give feedback, you can go to the MathML.us website. So thank you if you have any question.
And what's the support in Internet Explorer or Edge or whatever?
Sorry?
In Microsoft Explorer or?
Okay, so in Internet Explorer there is no MathML support. And in Blink either.
Okay, just in case.
What about Edge?
I don't know about Edge, but I haven't heard. I know that someone mentioned MathML flexibility, but I don't know what they do. Maybe they have more information.
Well, I know it's not a question, so so I will not comment now, but I don't know what's in Edge. Independent of accessibility.
Do you have any interaction with W3C, either the working group or W3C people?
What do you mean by integration?
About MathML and different kind of support or...
Because there are many things I mentioned the MathML Association. Is what you mean?
Yeah.
Okay, so basically one of the directors of the MathML Association is one member of the MathML working group. So we have a good interaction. I don't know exactly what MathML working group are interested in. I think as a month they are not really developing MathML anymore. So we hope that we could work together to also of course improve, and if this specification, this document is needed, maybe you could write an implementation note, like a W3C note, and propose it to the competition. But at the moment the MathML HTML5 is just a graph, so we had feedback from browser developers and so on.
And the question, are you aware of any polyfill, JavaScript polyfill for other browsers?
So there is Mailchimp, which is a polyfill. Mm-hmm. But it is very slow, this is one of the problems. And of course, you don't have all the features like choosing arbitrary font. Any other question? Thank you.